Hello and welcome back to my channel Learn with Nikhil. So today we are going to study about spirals, or called as Archimedial spiral. The technical definition of a spiral is a curve traced by a point moving along a line in one direction while the line is rotating in a plane about one of its end. In short, a spiral is nothing but a spring, and the shape of a spring is called as a spiral. So here are the types of spiral. Here one end is bigger, smaller, or both the ends are of similar radius. So we have considered a sum where it says a 70 millimeter long line OA rotates about O at uniform angular velocity. A point P initially at A moves along OA at a uniform rate and reaches O. During one revolution of the line, draw the locus of point P for one revolution of line. So you have to draw a spiral, in short. So for that, first step, we will draw a circle with radius as 70 millimeter. Now, as it says, a 70 millimeter long line OA rotates about O. So here the center is O, and a 70 millimeter long link. So there is a link OA which rotates at O. So O is the center point, and this is a rod which I am drawing. This is OA rod, and it rotates around O and rotates about O. So the curve or the line traced by A is a circle. Now using this, we have to draw a spiral. So for that, next step is dividing the circle into 12 equal parts. You know the method how to divide the circle into 12 equal parts. Keep at all the points and then cut the arcs. Now with this, we have divided the circle into 12 equal parts. Join these lines. And we are done. Marking them as A1 to A12. This is a line OA. Now, as we have divided the circle into 12 equal parts, we will divide the line OA also into 12 equal parts. The procedure to divide the line into 12 equal parts, it's the same as you know. Divide the 45 degree line into 12 equal parts, then join the lines, end to end lines. Joining the end-to-end lines, and then with reference to that, drawing the parallel lines. You can divide the circle into 6 equal parts, 8 equal parts, as many parts as you want. But as you divide it into 12 equal parts, you have to divide the line into 12 equal parts. If you divide into 8 equal parts, you have to divide the line also into 8 equal parts. After marking the points on the compass, keep it on O. Take the distance at 2, draw a curve extending till A1, as you can see. Then reduce the size on compass from 3, draw the curve line till A2. Keep doing like this center as O, distance till 4, extend the curve till A3. Then from 5, extend the curve till the next line, that is A4. From 6, extend the curve till the next line, that is A5. From 7, extend the curve till the next line, that is A6. Continue this till the last point, that is 12. Now after doing all these curves till 12, you have to mark those intersecting points and name them as P1 to P12. So this first point I'll mark it as P1, then the second point I'll mark it as P2, P3 till P12. After marking all these points till P12, you have to just join these points using French curve. So aligning three or more than three points on the French curve, you have to join them. And after joining all these points, the curve which you get is called as a spiral. So as said at the start, spiral is a curve, it's like a spring. So you have to draw a spring, the path of a spring, you have to draw it. So for that you have been given a radius of a circle, and this is the type of a spring which has one side as the bigger radius and one side as a smaller or a zero radius. You can move the French curve as you want. Just try to align three or more than three points. Don't just try to align two points, try to find three or more than three points, then only you will get a smooth curve. So this curve which is formed is called as a spiral. So this was one type of sum where you have given only one diameter, that is the bigger circle, and the spiral ends at the center. Thank you for listening. Do subscribe to my channel. See you in the next lecture.